Ladies and gentlemen, Nick here, and welcome to my review of The Monuments Men, which is a 2014 war film that focuses on a group of curators and architects and artists trying to recover stolen artwork stolen by the Germans and return them to the countries that they have invaded and stolen from, so France, Belgium, the Netherlands, mostly the Western countries, because they can't really get there off. They're coming from America, and one Brit, and a German who's I think it was a Jewish German, so he's now fighting for the Allies so he can fight for freedom. So they're fighting the Germans, and also they're fighting against time to stop, towards later in the film, they're fighting against time to stop to get the art before the Russians take it, because they're not going to be returning the art to their countries. They're going to be keeping it for themselves, as payment for the loss of life, for all the loss of lives they've endured over the war. So yeah, so they're going to be taking the art as a sort of payment for all of that. So the Americans and this band of team, which is mostly made up of Americans, but one British guy who dies and a German guy who I think survives. He might die, I'm not sure. They have to get to the artwork of the Western European countries and Germany first. And it's a pretty good film. I think this is actually quite an underrated movie. Ignoring these critic reviews on this side. But yeah, I think it's an underrated movie. I think it's fun. George Clooney not only stars in this film as the main character, but he also directs, he's a producer, and he works on the screenplay. So this is very much a personal project for him. And also has his very own special feature. So this is very much a personal project for him, and he does a great job with the role, and he does a brilliant job as a director. He makes it look really interesting, really enjoyable. The script's really good. Matt Damon's also really great as his character, who gets quite a lot to do in France, not too much on the front lines, although there is this one tense moment where he steps on a landmine. Think of like in the Doctor Who story, Genesis of the Daleks, where the fourth Doctor steps on a landmine and Harry Sullivan has to put rocks underneath it to make it level. The guys here have to try and make the landmine a bit more level so that there isn't as big of an explosion, so that Damon's character can step off it. I also consider Damon's character the smartest character, decision-wise, following a scene where he declines cheating on his wife with Kate Blanchett's character. Now, whilst I think Kate Blanchett's character is the smartest character in the movie, I think Damon's, in terms of intelligence, Damon is the smartest in terms of decision-making. He wasn't that smart when he stepped on that landmine, but he probably didn't notice it. But he turns down cheating on his wife with Blanchett's character. And I highly respect that. I highly respect the guy from doing that. If the actual guy in live action did, I can certainly respect the character here. This is coming from someone who is kind of against cheating in a way, and adultery. Mainly due to the fact that I'm single and haven't gotten a girlfriend yet. So yeah, it's quite personal. But because of that, I'm kind of against cheating and adultery. I mean, it's okay when with womenizing, I'm fine with. I'm like with James Bond, because he doesn't have one person he sticks around with whilst going after other girls. I mean, apart from maybe in the film On Her Majesty's Secret Service, when he's sort of in love with Tracy and he's hanging out with these other girls. But I can look past that one. Other times, he's either with girls for a long time and he sticks with that relationship, or it doesn't last long enough for it to count as cheating in a way. So yeah, that's why I'm okay with womenizing. It's adultery I'm not a fan of, and I'm glad to say that Matt Damon's character doesn't do that. So well done Matt Damon's character. And speaking of Blanchett's character, she's a pretty good character. She's a great character, very intelligent. Sorry for any noise outside. Shut up, bloody birds. Don't get that in wartime France, do you? Well, maybe you do, I don't know. But Yeah, she's a good character. And also, I think the rest of the guys, they're all fun characters. Sadly, Hugh Bonneville's character gets killed in a fight in a church. And I think one of the other guys gets killed accidentally in a battle. But there's some really cool moments, and there's some fun characterization and some really great fight stuff. And I think it's all well directed and well executed. So, yeah, I think this is a really enjoyable, really entertaining film, and it's certainly a recommendation. It's not even, is it that long? It's nearly 2 hours. Okay, it's average length. It's a good 2 hour watch. If you want to see a war film that doesn't have too much, isn't too intense, and doesn't really, actually is a bit more obscure, if I focus on a more obscure angle of the war, so going after all this treasure and artwork, then this is the film for you. So I'm going to give The Monuments Men, I think I might give it an 8 in my reaction. I'm going to give it a 9 actually. I'm going to give The Monuments Men a 9 out of 10. I think it's 100% perfect. I do think it's a really good, really enjoyable film, and I totally recommend it and hope you all like it. Okay, so that's it from me. Thank you for watching. The next film review I will be doing will be Star Wars Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith. And I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye. Don't forget to click below to subscribe to the official Nicholas Payne Retro YouTube channel.